as grace remains of undeserved favor, it cannot become the lot of the proud. You can't just can't get grace. Let's remember that all we are talking about here is about alignment, getting aligned to God. Romans 14:17 tells us that the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. If you cast your mind back to some of the prayers we prayed this morning about the seven mountains, the mountains in our circumstances that constitute the kingdom of God. And if you look at the, if you remember the image there, we had these small mountains, education, culture, entertainment, family, religion, on all of them. Then we have this big mountain surrounding them, which tells us that all these are maybe what you call foothills in the totality of the kingdom of God. And the kingdom, the God of God is telling us that it is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And that means that when the will of God becomes done on earth as it is in heaven, the result is going to be righteousness, the result is going to be peace, the result is going to be joy in the Holy Ghost. These are the issues we are praying for our country this morning. And we all have roles to play in bringing about the will of God to come to pass on earth towards achieving this righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Let us just take a few steps back and look again. What is this alignment we talk about? What does it mean for something to be aligned to something? We've said generally that it means to be in a correct position relative to something else. But there are certain other words, certain other ideas that help us to understand alignment. One word is resonance. Resonance. Resonance is when one thing behaves according to what something else is doing. Each time I go around there and I